Hi everybody, this is Adam Morgan here from succeedwithadam.com, and I'm excited to shoot this video today because I'm going to show you how to create follow-up email series using AWeber. This is my email marketing software, if you will, of choice, and I've been using it for a little over a year now, and I've really enjoyed it. The inspiration to this video is my team member, Veronica Biggs, who has just signed up for second member in our business, so congratulations to her. And she is learning how to use AWeber. So I got on the phone with her today and I showed her how to use this. And I thought this would be a great video to show people. So, having said that, you need to create a list. I'm not going to show you how to create a list in this video, but you should already have a list. And now you want to create autoresponder messages. Now, as soon as someone signs up, you can set it up so that they receive a message. Every day, every couple days, every 4 days, you can schedule the messages to go out. I prefer every couple of days. I noticed that when I was sending out messages every day, I was getting a lot of people responding back saying, I don't want this many messages or this is spam. So every 2 days seems to work well for me. But again, in your market, I want you to test it. So let's create those messages. Roll your mouse over messages, hit follow-up series. If your AWeber is less than, if you've had your AWeber account for less than a year, you won't have some of the options that I have. For example, the previous message editor. This is what I used for the longest time. And when they updated it with the drag and drop email builder, I actually kind of felt like an old dog trying to learn new tricks. But since then, I've kind of nutted up, so to speak. And I've learned how to use this. So you just hit that button right there. You'll find AWeber is kind of slow, but once it loads, it's pretty fast. There are a lot of options here. Some of them I haven't used. I'll just show you how to use the ones that I use. You need to create a subject line. This is where your selling occurs because when someone opens their email inbox, all they see is your subject line, and you've got to make that interesting and captivating. You can personalize it. You can do first name, and then you can do. Have you seen this? Okay. This, when you put your mouse over this box right here and double click, this will allow you to edit the text in this box. So let's just go ahead and kind of mess around with this, okay? And let's say, that I was talking about a video and I wanted to link to that video. All I have to do is highlight this text right here, hit the link button, and then go ahead and put the URL of that video. Since I don't have a video, I'll just put the domain to my website. I've really loved that AWeber put this little valid thing here to show me that that link is correct. And then you just hit enter. But on the other hand, let's say that my link was messed up. AWeber actually highlights this thing red and then it says page does not exist. So that's pretty helpful. Okay. Okay. Oh, I messed up again. 16 with Adam. There we go. Okay. I recommend putting a picture. Oh, by the way, this box here is called a paragraph. So if you want to add another paragraph, you can, but I don't really know what the point of that is. So I just usually just edit this one. Oh, let's say you had this button here and then you wanted to add more paragraph, you could do that. That's what that's for. Okay. Now let's say that I want to add a picture. I recommend putting a picture at the bottom. All you have to do is upload a file. Okay. And to resize that image, just put your mouse over here and click and then drag. Okay. And then you can align it to the left or the right or the center. And then you can actually turn your image into a picture. I like to put paragraph next. Let's see here. To get out of what you're doing, you have to double click off, and then it will allow you to touch these. Otherwise, see how this went gray and I can't touch anything here? So just double click off and then put a paragraph here next to the picture. Double click it to edit it. And I can put another link here in the postscript if I want, and I can make it whatever I want. Okay, and the follow buttons, Facebook, I can do Adam Morgan, and then this is my Twitter. You'll have to, for the very first time doing this, you'll have to add your Facebook account. It will go to Facebook, and then it will ask you for your authorization. Same with Twitter, really easy to do. And then you'll always want to hit save. And then you can test it. Does the link work? Looking in the bottom left-hand corner, yes. Does the picture work? Does this link work? Yes. Facebook URL, yes. Twitter, yes. Now, to send this message, go ahead and hit next at the bottom and then interval. Number 11. So this message that I just created was number 11 in the follow-up series. And this, what the number that I put in here tells the software, okay, send this email out 2 days after the last message. Okay. And you can schedule it. You can have it go out at a certain time of the day if you want. You always want to track the clicks on the website links in the message. Hit save and exit. And it's loading because it's kind of slow. And then it should be right here. Hey, first name, have you seen this? That's the message that I just created. Now, let's say that I want to send this message before number 10. All I have to do is drag it right here and it automatically renumbers it. Pretty cool, huh? So, I actually don't want this because it was just showing it to you as an example. But that's how you create follow-up email series using AWeber. If you have any questions, feel free to get in contact with me below in the comments. Make it a great day. Bye-bye.